We'll consider one example on right circular cone. Question is, find equation of right circular cone. Find equation of right circular cone whose vertex is one minus one two, and axis is line x minus 1/2 equal to y plus 1/1 equal to z minus 2/-2, and semi-vertical angle and 45 degree. Semi-vertical angle 45 degree. The question is to find equation of right circular cone, and we already have discussed in the last session that to find the equation of right circular cone, you must have three things about that cone. First one is vertex, second one is direction ratios of axis, and third one is semi-vertical angle. Now in the example, what they have given, vertex is given, line axis, its equation in symmetric form is given, and semi-vertical angle is given. So let us note it in the diagram. Suppose this is the vertex V, which is given as 1-1/2, and the axis also given. Axis is x minus 1/2 equal to y plus 1/1 equal to z minus 2/-2, and semi-vertical angle, that is angle between generator line and the axis, is given as 45 degree. This is semi-vertical angle, and from the equation of axis, which is in symmetric form, x minus x 1/a equal to y minus y 1/b equal to z minus z 1/c, the denominators 2, 1 and minus 2 are the direction ratios of axis. So that also they are given indirectly. Therefore, direction ratios of axis are given as 2, 1 and minus 2. Where we will treat it as a A1, B1 and C1. Now, when the three things about that cone, right circular cone, are known, means vertex, direction ratios of axis and semi-vertical angle. If these three things are known, then the procedure for finding the equation of right circular cone is same for all examples. And what is that procedure? So for that, you have to first of all consider, let P, X, Y, Z be any arbitrary point, on the surface of cone. Suppose in the diagram we denote here the point P, which is on the surface of cone. Now what you can say about the line VP? The line VP will be generator line, as it is passing through vertex and the intersecting the guiding curve. The line VP is passing through vertex and also intersecting the guiding curve. It means it is a generator line. Now what you can say about direction ratios of generator line VP? Direction ratios of generator line VP are x minus 1, y plus 1, z minus 2. How we get this? By taking the difference between the coordinates, because we know that if the two points on the line are known, then the difference between the corresponding coordinates gives you the direction ratios. So here, x coordinate difference x minus 1, y coordinate difference is y plus 1, and z coordinate difference is z minus 2. That represents the direction ratios of generator line PP. Treat this as a A2, B2 and C2. Now what do we have? The direction ratios of line VP and direction ratios of axis are also known, and the angle between these two, which is a semi-vertical angle. We know that angle between the generator line and axis for right circular cone is called as a semi-vertical angle, and this angle remains same. So here we have to use the formula for angle between the lines in terms of direction ratios. So by using formula for angle between two lines in terms of direction ratios. What is that formula? If theta is the angle between the two lines and A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2 are the direction ratios of two lines, then the angle is given by this formula: cos theta is equal to A1, A2 plus B1, B2 plus C1, C2 divided by under root A1 square plus B1 square plus C1 square into under root A2 square plus B2 square plus C2 square. So in the example, theta is 45 degree, angle between the line VP and the axis is 45 degree. So we'll put that cos 45 is equal to, so put that A1, B1, C1, 2, 1, minus 2, and A2, B2, C2. So it is A1 is 2 into A2, x minus 1, 2 into x minus 1, plus B1 is 1 into B2, 5 plus 1, so 1 into y plus 1, then plus C1 is minus 2 into C2, z minus 2, means minus 2 into z minus 2, divided by under root A1 square plus B1 square plus C1 square, which is 4 plus 1 plus 4, into under root A2 square plus B2 square plus C2 square, that is x minus 1 bracket square plus y plus 1 bracket square plus z minus 2 bracket square. So we just have to simplify this, and after simplifying this, we'll get the equation of right circular cone. In fact, we'll get the equation in terms of x, y and z. But what is that x, y, z? X, y, z are the coordinates of any arbitrary point on the surface of cone. So as that point, arbitrary point, satisfy that equation will be the equation of right circular cone. So you just have to simplify this equation. Let us simplify. That implies cos 45 is 1 upon root 2 is equal to, this is 2x plus y minus 2z, collecting the variable terms, and then constant terms are minus 2 plus 1, that is minus 1 minus 1, and this plus 4, that is plus 3, divided by under root, this is root 9 is 3, into under root, this term as it is, x minus 1 bracket square plus y plus 1 bracket square plus z minus 2 bracket square. Now do cross multiplication and simplify this. This is 3 into under root x minus 1 bracket square plus y plus 1 bracket square plus z minus 2 bracket square is equal to root 2 into 2x plus y minus 2z plus 3. Now to remove this root, we have to take square on both sides. So squaring both sides. We get 3 square is 9 into this root will be removed. So what remains? 9 into bracket x minus 1 bracket square plus y plus 1 bracket square plus z minus 2 bracket square. Okay. Is equal to right hand side RHS square root 2 square is 2 into this bracket square, that is 2x plus y minus 2z plus 3 bracket square. It implies 9 into this bracket square is x square minus 2x plus 1 plus y plus 1 bracket square is y square plus 2y plus 1 and z minus 2 bracket square is z square minus 4z plus 4. This LHS simplification equal to RHS is 2 into bracket. Now this bracket square, inside the bracket we have 4 terms. This is first, second, third and fourth. So how to do this bracket square? Each term square. So first term square is 4x square, second term square plus y square plus third term square, that is plus 4z square, fourth term, that is plus 3 square 9. Now plus you have to consider 2 into product of 2 terms. So how that 2 terms you have to consider? First into second, first into third, first into fourth. Then further combination, second third and second fourth. And last you have to consider third and fourth. First second, first third, first fourth, then second third, second fourth and third fourth into 2. So that is 2 into, we will consider first into second, that is 2 into first is 2x, second is y, plus 2 into first into third, so first is 2x and third term is minus 2z, plus 2 into first into fourth, that is 2x into 3, 2 into 2x into 3, plus next we have to consider second into third, so it is y and minus 2z, so 2 into y into minus 2z plus 2 into second and 4, that is y and 3, so 2 into y into 3 plus last combination remaining is third and fourth, that is 2 into minus 2z into 3, so 2 into minus 2z into 3. So in the RHS bracket square simplification, what we have done? Each term square, that is first term square plus second term square plus third term square plus fourth term square plus 2 into first into second plus 2 into first into third plus 2 into first into fourth plus 2 into second into third plus 2 into second into fourth and last plus 2 into third into fourth. Now let us simplify this. So that implies in LHS multiply by 9, so it is 9x square plus 9y square plus 9z square minus 18x plus 18y minus 36z, and the constant term, this is 1 plus 1 plus 4 means 6, 6 into 9, that is 54, is equal to RHS. Now before multiplying by these two, let us simplify the inside terms first of all. So 2 into bracket, what you have, 4x square plus y square plus 4z square plus xy term, so this is plus 4xy, these terms we have considered. Then yz term, where it is, this is minus 4yz, so this term also I have considered. Then xz term, here it is minus 8xz, then x term is this 2 into 2 into 3, that is plus 12x. Then y term is this plus 6y, and then z term 2 into minus 2 into 3, that is minus 12z, and last constant term, that is plus 9 as it is. Okay, now multiply by that 2 on the RHS. LHS will remain same, 9x square plus 9y square plus 9z square minus 18x plus 18y minus 36z plus 54 is equal to RHS multiply by 2, so it is 8x square plus 2y square plus 8z square plus 8xy minus 8yz minus 16xz plus 24x plus 12y minus 24z and plus 18. Now shifting RHS to LHS, we have 9x square minus 8x square will become x square, 9y square minus 2y square will become 7y square, 9z square minus 8z square will become plus 1z square. Then this xy terms after shifting to LHS, xy, yz and the xz terms will become what? Minus 8xy plus 8yz plus 16xz. So these terms we have considered. Now what remains? X term. This minus 18x, this minus 24x, so minus 18 minus 24, that is minus 42x. Then 18y minus 12y, it will be plus 6y. Minus 36z plus 24z, so it is minus 12z. This also I have considered. And last 54 minus 18 will be plus 36. Now this is the final simplification. X square plus 7y square plus z square minus 8xy plus 8yz plus 16xz minus 42x plus 6y minus 12z plus 36 equal to 0 is the required right circular cone. You just have to take care of the simplification. While doing the simplification, you must do it very carefully so that final answer will be correct. It will match with the standard answer. Now for practice, you can solve this example. For practice purpose, I am giving this example. Find equation, find equation of right circular cone whose vertex is 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, axis is with direction ratios, axis is with direction ratios 2 minus 1, 4 and semi-vertical angle is 60 degrees.